Alright, I think I finally have enough hair not to be compared to Kenny Beats. Yo, what's up guys? Today, I'm gonna tell you how to make songs the way that Kenny Beats does. And I'm gonna show you a plugin that I've been using so much recently. It's really great.
First off, before this video starts, I just want to say that I put hours into these videos. I spent hours watching every episode of The Cave, looking and studying how Kenny makes his beats. That's why I'd really appreciate it if you were to check out my online shop. It's got drum kits, presets, and sample packs. There's also a complete pack that includes everything on the store together for a reduced price. It's the only way I make money from this channel, and I'd really appreciate the support. Now let's get into the video.
Firstly and most importantly, to nail down that Kenny beat sound, you're gonna need to get good at sampling drums. So what I've done here is taken a drum loop that I recorded of my friend playing drums at this local music shop. Then I sliced it and warped it, but made sure not to put it exactly on time to give it a more looser groove, which will sound awesome in the final product. Okay, now the next signature Kenny Beats technique that I employed here was layering the drums that I felt were a bit weak. So I added a new kick and a new snare. Here's how it all sounds together. Next thing is to find a killer sample. Some of my favorite Kenny Beats tracks that he's produced have had these insane, lush samples.
Ooh.
What's that guy that they say?
Now let me tell you something. Picking the right sample and slicing it just the right way is an art. But what I do suggest is you go on YouTube and look for sample playlists. You can search, for example, soul samples playlist, R&B samples playlist. You'll find it. There's tons of playlists on YouTube. Go and download them and then bring them into a DAW. I ended up sampling Much Better Off by Smokey Robinson and The Miracles. And now you might be wondering, what is this weird interface you've pulled up? Well, I'm glad you asked. This is Serato Sample, and I've been using it on so many tracks recently. It really makes sampling songs that much easier. It's really amazing. I suggest you go check it out. I'm not sponsored by them, but like seriously guys, you're missing out without it. It just takes all the hassle out of sampling. So what I did is I pitched the sample and warped it to this tempo and sliced it like this. And the next thing I did to add a more cleaner sound was record my own bass line, which I just took my bass direct into my interface and record a little bass line. If you wanted to, you could use a plugin. I chose to play a real bass because I felt like it. And here's how it sounds. Alright, now let's put it all together. Hope you guys enjoyed this shorter video. I really enjoyed making it. If you liked it, leave a like. If you really liked it, please consider subscribing. If you want to support the channel, go check out my online shop. Peace.